Hi, I'm Gary for Expert Village.
So I'm going to go ahead and continue doing that just by clicking the left mouse and just scrolling over the image. Now the brush size, which is really, it's the eraser, but it goes by brush size, which is that little circle that we see. It can be made bigger and smaller. So when I'm dealing with an image, now the only area that I really want to apply this effect to is basically right here around the mouth and nose on the face. So this whole entire image, everything else can pretty much be erased. Therefore, I want to make my brush size a little bigger, and it will make it much easier and quicker to erase the parts of the image that I want to take away from applying the effect to. So the way that we do that is there's a brackets key. There's two brackets key. They're actually next to the letter P on your keyboard. And the right bracket makes the brush size bigger. We see as I'm clicking it, we see that the circle is actually growing. And that is going to erase much larger areas of our image. As you see here on the bottom, I can just go one full swoop, and just really take out most of this bottom part of the image. And we can make it smaller by pressing on the left bracket, and it gets smaller. And that's good for going around more detail when we want to be very careful on the parts that we're erasing. So I'm going to go ahead and using the brackets key, I'm going to start erasing parts of the image. And you might have to just keep clicking. Usually you can hold down the mouse, but if you see that it's not going on the screen, you might just want to give another click. And I'm basically taking out all of the areas that are not affected by this the skin issue that we're trying to clear up. Now I have a little bit of areas here on the forehead, so I'm not going to erase those. I'm going to apply the effect to those areas as well. And the nice thing about it is that you really don't have to be so exact and get right onto the edges of the area that you're looking to apply the effect to. And that's because the effect is not so pronounced. It's a blur, and so it doesn't really matter where those edges are, as long as you're close enough and you don't want to do anything that is going to make the image distorted. But as long as you just really get close enough, you can see that the effect will have a nice results to it, and you don't really have to worry about how close you came to the actual area.